One of the ideas that we like to talk about is converging themes. So multiple powerful disruptive themes that are happening simultaneously. So when we see robotics and artificial intelligence starting to emerge, of course there's a macroeconomic backdrop that's powering it. There's things like rising labor costs, demands for higher quality, shrinking workforces, but there's also other technological developments that are really powering robotics going forward. So one of those is the Internet of Things. That's building sensors that can be connected to the internet to transmit information. So if you think about how that applies to robotics, in the past, you really just had one central control that would tell a robot what to do. Now, if you attach a bunch of sensors to a robot, one, it can start to really see its environment, and secondly, it transmits that information back to the network so that every robot on that network can learn from that information. So what that does is it means the learning curve for robots becomes exponential. Every robot on that network is learning something and transmitting that to the kind of the bigger pond of robots that are connected to it. So this is really powerful in places like warehouses, where you have potentially hundreds of robots that are working together. And you know, if one robot learns that they're out of some product on a shelf, you don't have every other robot trying to find that product and realizing it's not there. So that can make a lot of efficiencies in the robotic space. And the second trend that's really powering it going forward is lithium and battery technology. So robots don't have to be plugged in anymore. They're freed to wander around a hotel if it's one of these like bellhop type robots. They're free to travel around warehouses if it's one of these warehouse robots. That completely opens up the potential for a robot to do all kinds of tasks that previously just wasn't able to do because it had to be attached to a power cord. There are certain companies that I think are very well positioned to benefit from this trend. So specifically companies involved in automation. So these are companies that are building the robots that really started back in the 1970s in the automobile industry, but now are really expanding to all parts of the economy now. I also think companies involved in artificial intelligence, building the chips, building the software that's now powering these robots are going to be very well positioned. And then more on kind of the consumer side of things, the companies that are building robots for people's homes, vacuum cleaners that are robotic, or builders of surgical robots that are now being used in healthcare. So companies kind of outside of the industrial automation space that are building robots for everyday life.